Assalamu alaikum. The lecture today is Pediatric Oncology Emergency. As in general pediatric, there is some of the cases may be present as emergency, like decay, heart failure, acute asthma, septic ellipticus. In oncology, the same things. Some of the condition may be present as emergency, and if not take action immediately, or treat the child thoroughly may be lead to the life-threatening condition and death of the child. In this lecture, what you should know? You should know the most important pediatric oncology emergency. How you deal with this condition? As this life-threatening condition, you should take action immediately. Any delay or any mistake in treatment may be lead to the death of the child. Why are oncology emergencies are important? If we treat the child thoroughly from this condition, we avoid end organ injury like renal failure, maybe heart problem, or maybe brain insult. If we avoid end organ injury, this may be improve the quality of life of the child. So avoid end organ injury and avoid compromising the long-term quality of life. Need to be addressed before therapy can begin or continue. You should know the exact treatment for each condition. Any mistake may lead to the death of a child. Any mistake in treatment, I mean. You should know thoroughly about the treatment of each condition. The cause of this condition, either due to disease related, tumor lysis syndrome, as mentioned, and the leukemia, anterior mediastinal mass, spinal cord compression, disseminated intervascular coagulation, leukocytosis and leukostasis, hypercalcemia, or due to treatment related, fever and neutropenia. As you know, because of suppression of the bone marrow by chemotherapy, lead to the severe neutropenia. Neutrophil less than, maybe reach less than 500, and lead to the sepsis, septic shock, and death of the child. Or cerebral vascular accident, either due to drug, or due to thrombocytopenia, lead to the severe intracranial hemorrhage, lead to the maybe lead to the stroke. Diphyllitis, especially in the patient who received vincristine, the child may present with acute abdomen. Or pancreatitis, the child may be present diabetic like form, increase in blood sugar, and treat as diabetic. Methotrexate toxicity, used in the case of leukemia. This is lead to the renal failure. Or transretinoic acid syndrome, because of use retinoic acid in some cases, especially in the acute myelocytic leukemia M3, lead to the brain insult or CNS manifestation. Veno-occlusive disease, either due to the chemotherapy or the disease itself. Veno-occlusive lead to the viscosity of the blood and the thrombosis. Hyperleukocytosis and leukostasis is the life-threatening pediatric oncology emergency that requires immediate initiation of therapy. How we define hyperleukocytosis is generally accepted when white blood cell count is more than 100,000, and some cases may be even higher than 50,000, and most frequent occur in the infantile acute lymphoblastic leukemia, T-cell leukemia, subtype of ALL, AML, acute myelogenous leukemia, and chronic myelocytic leukemia. As the sequelae of hyperleukocytosis may lead to the leukostasis. Leukostasis is stasis of leukemic cell within the blood vessel. And migration of blood cell into tissue can lead to the clinical entity of leukostasis. Because of high count, lead to the increased viscosity of blood, stasis of the blood, lead to the migration of blood cell and tissue. And this occur most frequently in the acute myogenous leukemia M4 M5. And the clinical symptom of the leukocytosis may be occur when a higher blood count, 200, 300, especially in the acute lymphoblastic leukemia. And leukocytosis may be occur even the high count in the patient with white blood cell 100. Yeah, it may be occur in very high count, 200, 300, thousands, and some cases maybe even 100 thousands, then patient may be present with leukocytosis. Is leukocytosis the sequelae of the hyperleukocytosis and leukocytosis? The clinical symptom of leukocytosis depend on the system affected. Any small vessels or any organ, pulmonary and neurological symptom. Hyperleukocytosis lead to the leukocytosis, and maybe lead to the renal failure, papillary edema, lactellitis, priapism, acute myocardial infarction, and cardiac failure. Some cases may be to the some of the cardiomyocardial infarction and cardiac failure, the most common presentation in our center. Clinical presentation also may be present with asymptomatic, sometimes the even high count and leukocytosis, but there's no sign or symptom. Sometimes the clinical leukocytosis can be present subtly and recover rapidly without any significant. Sometimes may be present with pulmonary symptom, tachypnea, oxygen desaturation, dyspnea, progress rapidly to the acute respiratory syndrome and lead to the respiratory failure. Sometimes the child may be present with neurological symptom, headache, tinnitus, ataxia, behavior change, seizure, and stroke. This is all the feature due to the leukocytosis. Hemorrhagic stroke is high complication of hyperleukocytosis, especially in M3. Symptom may be caused by release of the intercellular component of blast cell after lysis, including enzymes, especially cytokines, and injury in surrounding tissue, and lead to the alveolar damage and interstitial pneumonitis. Treatment. How to treat the child with hyperleukocytosis and leukocytosis? Hydration is very important. Iron recognition and urobilinol to prevent tumor-lysis syndrome, and this may be occur. And urate oxidase decrease the risk of tumor-lysis syndrome. Cranial radiation to decrease the chance of intracerebral hemorrhage. You give 400 to 600 rad. Sometimes use low dose of prednisolone or exchange transfusion. Leukapheresis, but you don't do in the child of the body weight less than 12 kg, or hydroxyurea to reduction in the number of white blood cell by leukapheresis, reduction of the cell, and hydroxyurea also lead to the reduction of the white blood cell. The other oncology emergency is mediastinomas. You should know about what is mediastinum. It's defined as the anatomic compartment bounded by the sternum, thoracic inlet, and anterior border of the heart. The mass in this area can cause either superior vena cava syndrome, tracheobronchial compression, the child present with wheezy child, or severe spinal distress, and compression of the heart or pulmonary vessels. What type of cancer can cause mediastinomas? Non-Hodgkin lymphoma. Acute lymphoblastic leukemia, especially T-type, Hodgkin's disease, neuroblastoma in the chest, and germ cell tumor, and sarcoma. This is due to the secondary metastasis. How to treat the child with mediastinomas? Embryo treatment. Some cases may be radiation, radiotherapy to the child if the severe distress, or you give intravenous steroid. Dexamethasone 0.2 to 2 mg per kg every 6 hours per day, or methylprednisolone 32 mg per square meter per day IV, give every 8 hours. Give this lead to the reduction of the mass and maybe get improvement. If not response, we can give combination therapy, the embryo treatment, cyclophosphamide, vincristine, and anthracycline. Anthracycline like doxorubicin, adriamycin, donorubicin. This is one of the empiric treatment in the patient with mediastinomas. This is the measure life-threatening measure. Sometimes we give this approach of a treatment before you take any biopsy from the child. Spinal cord compression. This is also one of the emergency. Maybe occurred in the child with cancer. Most about 75% of the tumor that cause spinal cord compression are extradural, not inside the dural space. And more than 50% of the tumor causing spinal cord compression is arises from lymphoma, neuroblastoma, soft tissue sarcoma, Ewing sarcoma, and rhabdomyosarcoma. A clinical presentation of this child with spinal cord compression. Either the child may be present with severe backache, ataxia, gait disturbance, localized spinal tenderness, paraplegia, and sphincter dysfunction may be lead to the renal retention or constipation. Treatment of this patient, either the severe paralysis of the lower limb is surgery, laminectomy, is the most important common surgical approach to relieve spinal cord compression caused by tumor. If delay may be lead to the permanent paralysis. The disadvantage of this laminectomy is high risk of late effect, maybe kyphosis or scoliosis. The other things, we can start chemotherapy, especially in the patient with Ewing sarcoma, neuroblastoma, spinal cord compression, lead to spinal cord compression, we start immediate chemotherapy. The empiric vincristine, cyclophosphamide, and anthracycline group. And some cases of the leukemia, if there's infiltrated of the spine, chloroma of the spine cord, this may be also lead immediate chemotherapy. Dexamethasone. What is the role of dexamethasone in the patient with the spinal cord compression? Minimize the effect of vasogenic edema and venous congestion, and decrease swelling cord and minimize neurological damage. Sometimes we use of gastric restoration is advised with dexamethasone, like H2 blocker and proton pump inhibitor, like ibrazole. We give rapid administration of dexamethasone for 1 to 2 days, over 30 minutes. The dose is 0.25 to 0.5 milligram per kg per dose every 6 hours. Radiotherapy. Sometimes you use radiotherapy, but as you know, there is complication of this radiotherapy. Long-term effect may be stunted growth, cord damage, scoliosis, thyroid dysfunction, second tumor. The dose of radiotherapy is 18 to 40 gyr or 30 gyrat in 10 fraction or 20 gyr in 5 fraction in 3 to 4 weeks. This is diagram show how the spinal cord compression, either it will paraplegia, either paraplegia, immediate laminectomy, and the progress may be normal, or no paraplegia, you give dexamethasone or chemotherapy if no response. If the improve is okay, continuous treatment. If no effect, go to the laminectomy. This is a photo of children who survived the cancer in our center. In Basra Pediatric Oncology Center and the Basra Children's Specialty Hospital. All the children is with leukemia and lymphoma, they are survived. And so the candle lose nothing by lighting another candle. This is give the hope to the other children who are still on treatment. And this is what they put in our center. It may be see in the future in the oncology center when you visit in the 6 year. This is what you call survivor tree. You put all the children who survive, look like this in the tree. And this is we give up hope to other children who are still on treatment or who finished treatment and still on follow up. So our aim to keep survive of this children by appropriate treatment, appropriate follow-up, and prevent sequelae of the disease. And thank you for listening. Any question, I am ready to answer.